Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, you're going to hear me go on a little bit of a clickbaity rant here, but I hope it'll be entertaining for you. My name is Jason Turner, and I am available for on-site training, code reviews, if you're interested in that kind of thing. And you should also check out the links in the video description for upcoming classes that might be in your area at a conference, such as ACCU in Bristol, England, CBPCon, C++ on C, etc. In this episode, I am going to talk about C++ 23's invoke R. Let's go ahead and make a quick demonstration reminder of what the invoke library function does. First of all, this is in the functional header, and we're going to go ahead and enable C++ 23 mode. If I have a callable of some sort, such as get value here, I can invoke it with some input like this. And this is a particularly helpful function in the case of generic code where you have some sort of callable and you don't know if it's a member function or a free function or a lambda, and you have a set of arguments that you want to pass to this thing. So as we can see here, this getValue function always adds 23 to the input, and then main always returns 33 because that is 23 plus 10. Now, invoke R exists so that you can specify the return type like this. This doesn't compile because I am trying to return a float from main, which expects an int, and I have wconversion with wError turned on. So let's go ahead and just print this out instead. And as we can see, this compiles with no problem. I am printing the floating point value of 10 plus 23. Now, I have two problems with this, and I will demonstrate them. Let's go ahead and make another function that returns a string view. This is perfectly valid and safe C++ code with no undefined behavior because string literals are valid for the lifetime of the program, and I am returning a string literal as a string view here. Now, this time, I want to call invoke R, and I want to say convert this thing to a string on the return. This is something that you might expect to be able to do because you can construct a string from a string view, and it is going to copy the underlying characters and make a new string object from that. This does not compile, and it says that there's no matching overload. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation for invoke R. Of course, we're going to use CBP reference for this because this is the best tool for this. Now, here it says the value returned by F implicitly converted to R. So it must be an implicit conversion that exists, and string views are not implicitly convertible to strings. They are explicitly convertible to strings. And we could see here that if I use the normal version of invoke, such as this, and were to explicitly create a string from this return value, then I would get the expected behavior. This is my concern number one. We don't want implicit conversions in our code, so this only works with the feature that we're trying to avoid using in the first place. You might say an implicit conversion from 33 to the floating point representation, which is 33, is perfectly safe, and I might give you that and accept that. So let's turn things around a little bit. Now remember, I said I have dash w conversion with dash w error currently set, and I am invoking an implicit conversion from float to int. That is the definition of using this tool, and I'm not getting a warning. Why am I not getting a warning here? And that is simply because GCC and Clang both exclude their standard library implementations from warnings. So even though this code is generating a warning deep down inside of the C++ standard library, we're never going to get it to show us that warning. So we're invoking an implicit conversion, which we have explicitly asked to not allow, and it's allowed because it's happening in the standard library. And I can prove this to you. If I enable dash W system headers in GCC, dash W system headers, and we can clearly see in the hundreds of lines of warnings that are being generated, if I know thousands of lines, 2,251 lines of warnings that are being generated, if I scroll to somewhere near the bottom, then I should at some point, no, that's still not going to find it for me. I have to actually search for it down in here. Let's see. Required from here, error conversion. Okay, there we go. We finally see where the error is happening on somewhere deep down inside of this code. So this is code that only invokes implicit conversions and hides errors from you. This is a tool that shouldn't exist on GCC or Clang. Let's go ahead and test this with Visual Studio. Warning, return conversion from float to result type, possible loss of data. I don't even have to enable extra warnings to be able to get this warning from Visual Studio, because Visual Studio does not exclude itself from warnings. It's okay for this library function to exist on Visual Studio because Visual Studio does not exclude its own standard library from generating warnings. It's clearly not a safe and helpful feature with GCC and Clang because they have made this decision to exclude themselves from warnings. All right, there's my rant. I hope you enjoyed this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, check out upcoming training that I have in your area.